Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at some advanced Google Maps techniques. So Google Maps has been around so long now that there's so many cool advanced techniques that a lot of people that use it every day don't ever take advantage of. For instance, let's say that we want to get directions from Denver to Grand Junction. Now it's going to draw us a route here, but let's say that we want to alter that route. Right now it's point A and point B, and it kind of gives us the best route possible. We can go to Show Options here, and we can do things like avoid highways. So it'll plot out a route now that will avoid highways and take us a more scenic way. We can also avoid tolls as well. Let's go back to the highway route, and let's say that we want to alter the route specifically and say, boy, it'd be nice to stop in Aspen on the way. So we can drag a point from the road here, from the route, and bring that down. There we go. And put it near Aspen. There we go. Put it right there. So you can see now it reroutes it, giving this as a midpoint between Denver and Grand Junction. Give it a little bit of a detour, and you can see it adds quite a bit to the trip, but it does give us where we want to go. And we can add more to this as well, so we can drag out another point if we wanted to, and you could actually watch it change live as you move it around. And I'm showing you a pretty big map here of an entire state, but you could do this with just simple directions, just 10 blocks, and just show different routes through your part of town. Now here we are zoomed in to street level, and we can see the streets here, and you can control click or secondary click, I'm going to use two fingers on my trackpad, and get a little pop-up menu here inside the browser. And you can zoom into here or get directions to or from here. So if you don't know the name of the place or the specific address, you just know generally where you want to go, you can start getting directions from here. You can also do what's here, which will then give you a little street view look here and give you some links to explore this area there. And it also drops the marker there, which then you can use to jump into street view or more here. Of course, these little marks are more useful if you're actually going to a place. Like, for instance, here's the name of a bar downtown, and I can click on it now, and it will bring up more information about this place, including a URL and reviews and directions and things like that. You can even edit details of a place, and then this will bring up some suggestions where you can change. So if you see some errors, this is one of the ways to correct them. And if you're the owner or proprietor of an establishment and you want to actually correct it, you can start here as well. Of course, the key to most advanced features in Google Maps is the ability to go over here and look in this menu here. You even expand it to get more. So for instance, you can turn on traffic, turn that off. You can turn on terrain here to show that, which you're not going to see much of in the city, but for other places it will show up. And also you can turn on things like photos, webcams, even videos here, and it will add all this stuff to the map. So you can click on, say, a photo of what's at a certain location. And you can also look for videos as well that are geotagged for that location. So there's all sorts of cool things you can find and explore using the photos and videos and webcams feature. Another cool feature of directions that you probably already know about is you can click on these icons here and change from driving directions to public transportation directions, and it even gives you the routes where you have to and how long it should take to get to them and things like that. You can also switch to walking directions and bicycling directions, and it will turn on the bicycling overlay here, and you could see where bike routes are, whether they're street routes or bike trails that'll help you get from one place to the other. Another thing I like to do with Google Maps is instead of giving somebody directions, if they're going to meet me somewhere, say, I give them a location because I don't really know where they're coming from and you know what maybe the best route is, or maybe giving them directions to Google Map isn't the best idea. Let them decide how they want to get there. They just need to know where it is. So I'll find a spot. So I'll maybe search for a place and find it there, and then I have the place located there. And what I'll do then is I can go and go to the link and give them the link, and you can hit short URL, which will give them this really short URL that you can copy and paste into an email. And then when they get that email, they can click on that link and then it gives them the Google Map location. Now they can go and hit get directions from where they're located. And if they get this on their phone, say, they could actually hit get directions and it'll take them from where they are. So it's the best way sometimes just to give them a location spot and instead of directions. It also works great for invitations or for meetings or something where people are coming from all sorts of different locations. Instead of giving them some general directions, just give them the location and then let them use Google Maps to figure out the exact directions to get there. So as I said, Google Maps has been around for a while now and there's lots of cool interesting features. If you've got some advanced tips, leave them here as comments to this post at MacMost.com. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it'll just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. Go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.